page of the practice test.
No.
Exactly like the quiz you just took, right?
Oh, no.
So here we go. Question number one. Y equals x squared minus x minus 6 over x squared minus 4. I know that you are sick of these, but you, this is a lot of points on this one page. So let's see if we can get all these points
right. Is this it right here?
It's called practice test.
Wait, is it the graph?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Now, if you can't find yours, then just take a picture of someone's because we need to get going. All right, step one. Here's the problem. The problem is written down below this time, but here it is. What do we do first? Factor. How does the top factor? Let's make sure we factor correctly. Top will be what?
Minus 3 plus 2.
What will the bottom be?
X plus 2, X minus 2.
There we go. And then we notice that we have a cancellation, which means that our problem will have a hole.
Negative
2. The hole will be at the point where X is negative 2, because that's the thing that canceled out, right? X plus 2? So now I'm going to plug negative 2 into my box here. So I will get negative 5 over negative 4. 5 fourths?
Yeah.
So on my picture, I'm going to go ahead and plot that right now so I don't forget. Negative 2 comma 5 fourths is my open circle. Everybody okay? All right, what else do I need to put in there? I need to fill in a whole bunch of blanks. What else do I need? I need a vertical asymptote. Now you can look right here at your equation and see that the vertical asymptote is going to be where x equals 2. I'm going to say it one more time. Vertical asymptotes come from where the denominator is 0. All right, what else? Horizontal asymptote comes from right here. So that's going to be at 1. So make sure you are labeling on the graph and filling in the blanks. All right, now what? I need the intercept, so that's when we set up our t-chart and we let each letter be 0 one at a time. So come back to the box. What happens if you put in zeros? You get 3 over 2. And then we're going to let y be 0. Some of us are still missing this. I don't know. We're not multiplying both sides by x minus 2. So 0 equals x minus 3. So x equals 3. And that is it. All the blanks now are filled in. Right? So now we have to somehow connect the dots and make a picture. And we remember that we always have curves that are in opposite corners, right?
Yep.
So the fact I have a point down here leads me to believe I have that. And then I got 2 points up here. So I have that. And there is your picture. That's page 1 of the test. Done. Anybody wonder where one of those numbers came from? Please remember, when you do draw your picture, it has to look like that. Right?
Yes.
Don't draw something else weird. It has to have that shape. Okay, next page.
Yonkari.
Solve the following. Now, want to say two things about this section. Do you see how at least all on this page are inequalities?
Yep.
That is less than to greater than? All right, I want you to remember that if you have an inequality, two things have to happen. One is it's got to be a zero on one side. You got to have a zero on one side. The other thing is you're going to use the number line to solve it. Okay? So you need, when you look at problem number A, you know, because Ms. Ford just told you, you got to have a zero. You don't. So what are you going to do? What is going to give you a zero?
Subtract 6x.
That gives you a zero. Now we're going to go to the number line. And you know, because you've done so many of these, we're going to put some dots on the number line, right? Where do the dots come from?
What makes it equal zero?
They come from the factors, don't they? Don't they come out of the parentheses? Well, wait a minute. I don't have any factors, so what am I going to have to do?
Zero.
I'm going to have to factor it.
Oh.
I'm going to factor it. How does that factor? What could I do to that?
Take out an X.
Perfect. So where will the zeros be? There's only going to be two of them.
Zero.
One will be at zero and one will be at
six.
Should those dots be colored? Sometimes they are.
Yes.
Is this a problem where they're colored?
They will be colored. Then you plug in.
Now, I like to plug in zero, but I can't this time.
One,
because
two,
you got to plug in a number that's not a dot.
Two
is fine. Two is here. So if I plug in two, I would get 2 times -4.
-8.
Is that bigger than zero?
No.
So that means the part of the number line where two is can't be colored. So that means this section is, and this section is.
Wait,
put a 2 in for the X's. What's 2 minus 6? So my answer is -∞ to 0. Make sure you have a parenthesis on the infinity and a bracket on the 0. Or 6 to ∞, same thing. Brackets and parentheses. Personally, I think the next question is the hardest one on the test. If we can get through this one, I think we have smooth sailing. We practiced one of these yesterday and the day before, so we've actually practiced these now for 3 days in a row. What did I tell you about these inequalities? What do we have to have?
Zero.
We gotta have a zero. Well, we don't have a zero, so what shall we do?
Subtract 6.
Now, do you remember what to do? We've only done a couple of these. Jack, get your head up, please. We've only done a couple of these. What do we do?
6 over 1 multiply by x.
We're going to get a common denominator. So we're going to multiply this by x+3 over x+3. So now, do they have the same denominator now? Yeah, the 1 doesn't hurt anything. So aren't they the same denominator now? Yep. So we can write 1 fraction, x+3 on the bottom. Now what will be on the top? x minus 2 minus 6x Minus 18. So, collecting like terms. Negative 5x minus 20. Factor a negative 5 out of the top. Watch it though. If you're taking out a negative 5, it will become x plus 4. Now that step is not required, but it helps, I think, figure out where the dots are. We're ready now. We factor. We're ready to put the dots on. Where would the dots be this time?
-4, -3.
Exactly. Make sure you get them in the right order, kids. They go in this order. That's the order they go. And one of these dots, and only one, has to be color then.
How'd you get those?
They're the opposite of what we got here. Same way as we always get them.
So which one gets colored?
-4.
-4 gets colored. All right, so I'm going to stop here before I start shading and answer whatever questions we have. What questions do we have? Because it's an or equal to problem.
So I'm shading.
Why don't we shade the -3? We talked about that.
It's zero.
The denominator cannot equal zero, so you would never want x to be -3, no matter what.
So that -5 doesn't
mean anything? It impacts our answer where we shade, but it's not a dot because it doesn't have an x. Only the x's give us dots. Okay, can I use 0 this time?
Yes.
Yep, so I think I will. 0's out here. So I'm going to see what happens if I put in 0. So if I put in 0, what do I have on the top?
-20.
What do I have on the bottom?
3.
3. Is -23 less than 0?
Yes.
So this is going to get shaded. And this is going to get shaded. So my answer is everything from negative infinity to -4, and that one's a bracket. Or -3 to infinity, and that one is not a bracket.
So it's like a pattern. If you shade one side, like on the outside, and you shade the other side, and you shade the inside.
Yeah, we talked about it all the time. Alternating, it alternates.
Yeah.
As long as there are no factor squared. Like if you put a squared on that, then that doesn't work. But as long as there are no factors on there, yes, it alternates. Shaded sections alternate.
Why'd you put a bracket on a -4 but not the -3?
Because the -4 is colored in and the -3 is not, because denominator dots can't be colored in because the denominator can't be zero.
So whenever it's colored, it's a bracket?
Yep.
Okay. The denominator is always meant to
be
zero.
All right, that's the toughest one, I think. I think all the rest of them are pretty easy. Next one's easy. Well, what makes the next one kind of easy is the factors are already there.
Why do you look at this?
Okay, Zach.
Sorry.
She does not need any distraction. Okay. Now, this problem is already factored, and it already has a zero, so we're ready to go straight to the number line, right? The dots on the number line would be at -4 and 1. Are they colored?
Yes.
No denominators to worry about. It's an or equal to problem. The dots are going to be colored. Now, you know the pattern Jack was just talking about, the alternating thing, not going to happen in this problem because of this. So we're going to have to do 3 different checks. So what is a number out here?
-5.
-5. So if I put negative 5 in here, I get negative 1 squared, which is 1. And then I put negative 5 in here, I get negative 6. Is 1 times negative 6 less than 0?
Yes.
Yes. So that works. All right, now I'm going to try a number in here, which might be 0. 0 plus 4 squared, 16. 0 minus 1, negative 1, is 16 times negative 1 less than 0.
Yeah.
Yep. Shoot it in. Now I'm going to try a number out here, like 2. 2 plus 4 squared, 36. 2 minus 1, 1. Is 36 times 1 less than 0?
No.
No. So that doesn't get shaded.
Wow.
So what is the answer to this question? Actually, you can write it like this. Because even though I did it in two sections because of the dots, because they are connected to each other, and everything's colored in, I can just write it as one answer. See that? I had to do it in two because of the dots, but they ended up being connected. Max said continuous. They ended up
so being the brackets basically say ends at one, no more than one.
Right. It says that we're colored in at one. All right. D. Remember, your test is going to have one of each kind of these on it. Okay. What do I need to do? You got to move the 15 over. You got to have a 0. Now, I'm also going to be using a number line, right? And I would expect there to be 3 dots on this number line. Why would I expect that?
Because
it's x cubed, right? But here's my dilemma. Where do I put the dots? I have no idea. I need to find the factors, right? And I need to do synthetic division. Because this guy, look at those numbers. Is that going to factor by grouping? No way. Now, here's the good news. What are the PRRs? There aren't very many.
5, 3,
15, 5, 3, and 1. Right? Plus or minus. So we're going to start guessing numbers from this list. And I'm even going to give you a better hint than that. In this particular problem, you see how all these are positive? You want to end up with a negative, don't you? I mean, you've got to have a negative in there to get a 0, right? If you just have all positive, everything's just going to keep adding up, right?
It's
negative. So we need to use a negative number. We're going to try a negative number. I don't care.
Negative 3.
I'm just saying it, and somebody said negative 3, so I'm just going with negative 3. It's a good thing to go with. Good job, people.
Hey, yeah. Wow.
There it is. That was a good guess.
Okay, wow. Dude. Wow.
All right, where do I go from here? I'm guessing a number, trying to get 0. I guessed 1. I got 0. What do I do now?
X squared plus 6x plus 5.
X squared plus 6x plus 5 is what I have left from my synthetic division. What about x squared plus 6x plus 5? it's going to factor as
x plus 5, x plus 1.
Now, wait a minute.
X minus 3.
I'm supposed to have three dots.
X plus 3
is the other one. Why is it plus 3? Because the number I used was negative 3.
Are all the circles closed?
The circles need to be closed in. And they need to be at negative 5, negative 3, and negative 1.
Going to be positive
1. The factor is x plus 3, right?
Yeah, I was reading it.
Yeah, this is the dot right here. It will alternate because none of these are squared. The only way it doesn't alternate is if you put powers on here. We don't. So I can pick one number. I like 0. So 0, which is out here, gives me 3 times 5 times 1, which is 15. Is 15 less than 0?
No.
No. So this didn't work, which means this won't. So my answer is negative infinity to negative 5. Or negative 3 to negative 1. What, Jack?
I don't know. I was just going to say that. I don't know if it's positive or no with the negative. So I don't know. Ugh.
Okay. Important thing to remember there is you've got to have three dots on that number line. Don't forget about this guy right here. E, this looks easy. Now, first of all, gang, E is not an inequality. Do not draw a number line. Do not get 0. It is not an inequality. It's an equation that has denominators 5x and 10.
10x.
So 10x. One option would be to multiply everything by 10x. That would take care of every single denominator. So 5 goes into 10 twice, 18x plus 30 equals 7x. Equals negative 11x. So x equals negative 30 elevenths. Not a nice number, but no one cares.
Do we ever do the number line?
No. We do not do number lines unless we have an or less than or equal to, or less than or greater than problem, right?
For sure.
We're just done with that. Is this the same kind of problem?
Yes.
Yep. Just a little bit bigger. But it is exactly the same kind of situation. So tell me how we should start. Be careful.
Factor the bottom.
You want to factor the bottom. And we have some people that have observed that this will more than likely be these two. And I can double check that by doing a quick FOIL.
It is.
But let that help you. That's almost always the case in these problems we get out of books. So what do we do?
Multiply by 2x minus 3x plus 1.
Well, we multiply, yes. Is that what you said?
Yeah.
So we're going to multiply by 2x minus 3 and x plus 1. 2x minus 3, x plus 1. 2x minus 3, x plus 1. Amy writing this down? Do you need to stand up and stretch?
No.
Do a burpee or two? Get that blood flowing?
What?
You're like sleeping. Now you're not sleeping, but you're really like getting ready to go to sleep.
Daydreaming,
yeah. Alright, so these cancel, what am I left with? 4x plus 4? Plus, these cancel, watch it. 2x squared minus 3x. Everything's gone, negative 8x. So when I start collecting like terms, I'm going to have 2x squared plus x plus 4 on this side equal to negative 8x. These two get added together. So I'm going to add that over, and I have 2x squared plus 9x plus 4. I'm going to add 8x over. It does factor. It also has a leading coefficient, though, and some of you don't like to do that. So you could use the quadratic formula, but it does factor. So 2x, x, plus 4, plus 1. So my answers, negative 1 half and negative 4. Pretty good?
Yes.
Last page.
Hey, really?
Yeah. And there's only two problems on the last page.
These are my favorite.
These are good. I'm glad. That will get you, get your blood flowing here. So now we've got our two word problems. Please note up at the top it says be sure to label your answer. So you know what's going to happen if you don't. Minus an 8. That's dumb. We already do that. So it's, if it's 18 gallons, it's 18 gallons, right? Or 6 hours, whatever it is. Here we go. Amount times percent plus amount times percent equals amount times percent. Now y'all act like you're bored. I tell you what, you better get it right then. How much 9% solution must be mixed with 3% solution? And remember, 9% and 3% are 0.03, 0.09. To end up with 15 gallons of 5%.
Over the left side there.
Where is the empty spot? Right here, right? What goes in the empty spot?
15 minus X.
15 minus X. Remember?
Yes.
You're either going to subtract your amounts or you're going to add your amounts. If that blank spot were over here, it would be 15 plus X. It's over here, so it's 15 minus X. So 0.09X. plus 0.45 minus 0.03x. This is a distributive property. Some of you aren't too good when you distribute that way, so turn that around and make it this. Maybe that'll make it easier for you to distribute. Equals 0.75. You'll have a calculator. I'm trying to do this without, but I might be making mistakes, so you'll have a calculator to help you with this arithmetic. So what do we got here? 0.06x equals 0.30. These two add together. That guy gets subtracted over there. So x equals 0.30 over 0.06, which I think is 5 gallons. Anybody have a question about that one? Now we're gonna paint a fence. So one over alone plus one over alone equals one over together. Here we go. Will and Zane can paint a fence together in 12 hours. Where does that go?
Together
is 12, so this is 1 over 12. It takes Will 15 hours alone. 1 over 15. How long does it take Zane? 1 over x. Now, you can multiply everything by 60x, because that will cancel out a 15 and a 12, but I don't want you guys stewing and fretting about that. You can multiply everything by 15, 12, and x. 15, 12, and x. This will work just fine, too. So if that's easier for you to do it that way, then do it that way. Your denominators are 15, 12, and x. That is not the least common denominator. 60 would be the least common denominator. But if it's easier for you to do it this way, go ahead. If I do it this way, I'm left with what?
12x.
12x plus?
60.
No, 15 times 12 is not 60. 15x. So 180 equals 3x. So x equals 60 hours. It takes Zane 60 hours to do it by himself. Beautiful. Test one, done. Let's
It's not over.
Let's go, since tomorrow we have a very short period, let's go ahead and start on practice test two, and we'll at least get the front page done. We'll get page one done.
What day is it tomorrow? Six?
It's not a day.
So we just have every class?
Yeah.
You
don't have this Friday because it's day seven.
Oh.
All right, so here we go. Practice test two. Here is our problem. Let's see if we can get it done. To save time, notice what I did at the very beginning. You see what I did? I'm on practice test two. You see what I did?
Yeah, you changed the difference.
I took out a 2.
Yeah.
So now I can factor. Now I got to keep the 2. Don't lose the 2. X plus 3, X minus 3. How about the bottom? How does he factor?
X plus 3.
Negative 4, minus 3.
Negative 4, negative 3?
Yeah.
And here we go. There's our canceling. So we're going to have a hole. And the hole will be where x is
3.
And I'm going to go ahead and plug 3 in for x in my box. And I get 2 times 6 over negative 1, negative 12.
Yep.
It's down there quite a ways.
Let's go with 2.
So 3. We can do that going 2s. So 3, negative 12. There's my open dot, 3, negative 12. All right, tell me what else. As soon as we're done with this problem, we can leave. Tell me what else.
The
vertical asymptote is going to be at x equals 4, because that's what makes the denominator 0.
The horizontal be 2.
The horizontal will be 2. Very good, Trent. Because this time we have 2x over x. 2x over x. So your horizontal is at 2. Very good.
Y intercept would be -3.
To find my intercepts, I'm going to put in zeros. So if I put 0 into my box, I get 2 times 3, or 6, over negative 4.
Looks like it's starting to
feel. Negative 3 halves?
That's a
y intercept. Yep, that's a y intercept. It's a y intercept. Look where I plotted it. Now I'm going to put 0 in here.
X equals 3.
I'm getting negative 3.
Negative 3, 0.
Negative 3, 0. Is that enough for you to draw your picture?
Yeah.
It should be. You're going to follow your asymptotes here off the page to the right and down and up and there we go.
Beautiful. When's Math League?
Math League is not next week. It's the next week after that.
So it's on Thanksgiving week.
Oh. We have our
essay. All right. So tomorrow, hopefully in our short little class, we can finish the rest of this practice test.
You know, Luke Sanders is getting his first collegiate start tonight.